Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Blazor Smith Chart of Synfusion. In general, the Smith Chart can be used as a tool to visualize the polar plot of the complex reflecting coefficients. You can see more number of circles and arcs or some rectangle plots to visualize the transmission loss in the high frequency circuit applications. So, in the same way, you can use the Synfusion Blazor Smith Chart to visualize such complex data and can easily analyze the comparison of transmission lines more clearly. To explore about the Synfusion Blazor Smith Chart, refer to the website link shown in the above YouTube card. So, in this video, I will let you know how to add Synfusion Blazor Smith Chart to a Blazor server app and explain you on how to enable few of its basic features like legend, tooltip, data markers, and data labels. Before I start to create a Blazor application, first I need to make sure whether .NET Core SDK latest version is installed in my machine and I should have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019. In this tutorial, I'm going to create a new server-side Blazor app. So, let me open the Visual Studio 2019 first and create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I will choose Blazor app and click next to proceed further with the project creation. Here, I will name my project as Blazor example and click the create button. Next, I will choose this Blazor server app option and click this create button finally to complete the project creation. Now, the project has been created and ready to use. If you want to know more about the Blazor server app and how to add Synfusion components to it, then you can listen to the video link that is shown in the above YouTube card. Now, I will tell you the steps to add Blazor Smith Chart. To start using the Synfusion Blazor Smith Chart, first I need to install the Synfusion Blazor NuGet package into my application. For that, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choose the option Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I will search for Synfusion Blazor in the Browse tab and install it into my project. Once the installation gets completed, let me navigate to imports.tracer file and here, I will add Synfusion Blazor Charts namespace to start using the Blazor Smith Chart in any of the components available under the Pages folder. Next, I will open the startup.cs file and here I will add the Synfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I will register the Synfusion Blazor service by calling a method addSynfusionBlazor within the configureServices method. Also, I should register the valid license key into my application. So, let me register the trial license key using the registerLicense method. The next important thing is, I need to define the CSS for Smith Chart component. Therefore, let me navigate to host.cshtml file under the Pages folder to refer the CSS file from the installed Synfusion Blazor package. Now, everything is configured, so let me start to add the Blazor Smith Chart. For that, I need to open the index.tracer component and here, I will include Smith Chart component by replacing the default code. Now, I will run this example. So here, you can see the default Smith Chart output displayed with no data points. Next, let me proceed to show you how to populate data to the Blazor Smith Chart. Now, I'm going to compare the impedance transmission, so I want to create a data source with the fields resistance and reactance. To populate the data to the chart, first I need to add code block. Here, the Synfusion Blazor Smith Chart series can be added in two ways, such as points and data source. From these two types, now I'm going to use point series to the Smith Chart. So, I will create a list point series of the predefined type I Smith Chart point and assigned values to the resistance and reactance fields as these two fields will be directly mapped to the Smith Chart series to render a Smith Chart. Next, I need to add series to the chart So let me define a Smith chart series collection tag first, which is of type array and can contain n number of Smith chart series definitions inside it. Here, I have planned to add single Smith chart series, so I will define a single Smith chart series tag. Along with this, I need to define the property points with the value point series, as I am going to bind point series to the Smith chart. Also, I will define the property fill with color code to display Smith chart series in custom colors. So here, you can see the Smith chart displaying impedance transmission line. Suppose if I want to bind data source series to Smith chart, then I need to make use of the property data source. Here, I'm going to add one more Smith chart series, so let me define a Smith chart series definition inside the Smith chart series collection tag. To add data source series, I need to define a model class chart data with two fields, namely resistance value and reactance value. Then I also need to create a list transmission series of type chart data and assign values to data source fields. Now I will assign this variable transmission series to the data source property of the Smith chart. For this data source property, the appropriate field should be mapped. So I will map the data source fields resistance value to resistance property and reactance value to reactance property. And now you can see the Smith chart displaying two impedance transmission lines. And now I'm going to show you how to set title for chart. To set title for chart, first I need to define Smith chart title tag and set its text property as impedance transmission. So here you can see the Blazor Smith chart displaying the main title as impedance transmission. Now I will proceed to show you how to add data marker and data label to the Smith chart to display information about the data points. To add data marker for Smith chart, I need to define Smith chart series marker tags for both the Smith chart series and set its visible property as true. Here, I am planning to add data label for first Smith chart series. Therefore, I will define Smith chart series data label tag and set its visible property as true. Look at the chart output now. You can see the data markers enabled for both the series. Also, you can see the Smith chart displaying data labels on each of its data point. Now, I'm going to add legend for Blazor Smith chart. Legend is a piece of information about the series in the chart. To add legend to the chart, I need to define Smith chart legend settings tag and set its visible property as true. Then I will set appropriate name to Smith chart series to show it as a label for those legend items. And here you can see the Blazor Smith chart showing the legend to display information about the series. Finally, I'm going to show you how to make the Blazor Smith chart more interactive by adding tooltips to it. To add tooltip to the chart, I will define Smith chart series tooltip tag inside the Blazor Smith chart code. Then, to enable the tooltip, let me define a property visible and set its value as true. See the output with tooltip shown for every data points of the Smith chart. Now, let me make a quick recap of what we have seen so far. We have seen how to create a Blazor project using Visual Studio 2019 and added a Synfusion Blazor Smith chart component in a server-side application. Also, we have seen how to render two types of chart series with basic features like legend, data markers, data label and tooltip. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which I have shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use a complete Blazor products if you fit into a community license guidelines. So check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. Also, If you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.